Bitcoin, Dogecoin, cryptocurrency, and pump and dumps. Oh my. You've heard a lot of news about crypto in the past couple of months. You maybe have even heard your friends talking about the money that they made on Bitcoin or Doge. Although they likely haven't told you about how much they've lost since they've gone down from their peaks. You might be wondering then, how do all those people on Twitter get rich off of cryptocurrency? Surely they can't all be using their influence to pump Bitcoin while at the same time hedging against decreases while shorting Bitcoin trusts, can they? The answer lies in the secret to getting rich, building wealth. And how does one build wealth? The answer is simple, time and money. Imagine you have $10 in the bank, which can earn you 10% per year. After a year, you will have made $1 in interest, and now we'll have $11 in the bank. The cool thing is that next year, you'll actually earn more than $1, $1.10 this time, because you're actually earning interest off of the $11, not just your original 10. This compounding force of interest was called the greatest force in the universe by Albert Einstein. Now, if you add in the idea that you can put a little money aside every now and again, we can talk about the future value of money. The future value of money looks at how much time your money has to grow, also called periods, how much money you will put aside each period, and the interest rate at which your money will grow. Using this formula on a very simple spreadsheet, we can see that if you start investing just $859.17 a year from age 18 to retirement at 68, assuming an average of 10% return based on historical returns from the stock market, you will have $1 million. That's just $71.60 every month. Or $16.52 every week. That's not a lot of work relative to making an actual $1 million, since most of the value actually comes from the interest on your money growing over time. In fact, only $42,958.70 of that million is actually money that you actively put away. Thanks, compound interest. For reference, you can actually put away a maximum of $6,000 per year and withdraw your gains tax-free if you use a Roth IRA, assuming you've made at least $6,000 of earned income that year. Of course, where to get this money is something we can struggle with, so I will have videos about side hustles, personal finance, and more coming out soon. New videos come out every Friday, so make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified when they come out. And please like the video if you're enjoying it. So to recap, getting rich is about building wealth. Wealth is built through two simple factors, time and money. So then, what's the secret to getting rich with crypto? It's by adding a third component, not actually investing in cryptocurrency, per se. Those of you who are really into crypto, Bitcoin especially, may be typing rebuttals in the comments right now. And please do. You might say, but Bitcoin is a hedge against inflation due to its cap supply, decentralized nature, and ease of peer-to-peer transactions. Well, let's go through some of these points. One, Bitcoin prices have not fared well against inflation recently, nor has gold for that matter. This is likely due to not being a real currency based on the three rules of a viable currency in economics. Namely, Bitcoin does not function as a medium of exchange, meaning that you can't pay for your groceries by using crypto, at least in most circumstances, or at least for right now. Next, Bitcoin does have a fixed supply of 21 million, but Bitcoins can be subdivided into Satoshis, like dollars can be broken down into change. In the event that Bitcoin becomes so valuable that not even Satoshis are viable for your average consumer, what stops users from voting a half Satoshi token into the protocol? While this does not impact the supply of Bitcoin overall, it does change the affordability of buying fractional pieces. Similarly, expensive stocks sometimes go through splits in which investors earn 2 to 4 shares per original share they owned to decrease the asset's price and thus make it more viable to be purchased by your average investor. Next, Bitcoin is decentralized, sure, but if the US dollar, the currency which backs most major functions in the world, including international commerce, becomes valueless, well, then we've got a lot more things to worry about than our retirement accounts or cryptocurrency. Next, Bitcoins and other cryptocurrency can be pretty easily sent peer-to-peer using things like QR codes and email. One issue, though, is that not every app shows the value of these transactions in US dollars, which may involve extra math by those involved in the transaction who have to convert the price of their cryptocurrency into dollars to make sure that they're sending the right amount that they want to. Do you know what services can do the same thing while resolving this issue? You've probably already used them, Venmo and PayPal. Additionally, they also have built-in protections to help users who have been scammed to recuperate their money. There is really no equivalent in crypto. Finally, here's a pop quiz. What's the value of a Bitcoin? If you answered the current market price in US dollars, congratulations, you kind of get my point. Bitcoin is worth what people are willing to trade for it in viable, spendable currency. Now, if I love dollars, also called fiat currency, and hate crypto, and trust me, I don't. I'm just making a point. How do I make money off of crypto? The answer, stablecoins. There are a few services that will convert your fiat currency into stablecoins, which have the same value as, or are pegged to, that currency at a one-to-one ratio. Think about buying something online. You charge your debit card, and money comes out of your account. The bank didn't really take your money. It just deducted how much it owes you if you were to ask for all of your money back at once. You can think about stablecoins in the same way. They represent how much you're owed should you ask for all of your fiat money back. And because they're a cryptocurrency on the blockchain, they can be used for all of the same things as Bitcoin, except it's a little easier to grasp for the average person because it's denominated in US dollars. So how can you use what we talked about in terms of compound interest to build wealth and get rich using crypto? The answer lies with cryptocurrency lending platforms such as Celsius, Nexo, or BlockFi. These services act very similarly to banks in that they pay you to hold your assets, except it is cryptocurrency rather than cash, and they typically give you a much higher interest rate. They typically make money by lending assets in their custody at higher interest rates, and usually while holding 2 to 4 times that loan's value is collateral. They can also provide liquidity to large institutional investors. I use Celsius because it offers the best interest rates on stablecoins, at least as of recording. As a disclaimer, please do your own research before deciding to use Celsius or a similar cryptocurrency lending platform, if at all. I am not a licensed financial professional. Furthermore, while this video is not sponsored, you can use my promo code in the description to earn $40 in free Bitcoin when you sign up for a Celsius account and make your first deposit of $400 of any asset and hold it with Celsius for at least 30 days. Celsius offers an 8.88% interest rate on stablecoins, which compounds weekly, meaning that you are paid interest every week. And since you are paid interest every week, the interest you earn is able to grow faster. Let's go back to the spreadsheet. By modifying the formula, we can introduce weekly compounding by changing the number of periods to weeks rather than years, and by dividing the annual interest rate by 52 to convert it to the weekly interest rate. Now, because the interest rate is 1.12% less with Celsius than the 10% average in stock returns we looked at earlier, the weekly deposit you would need to make increases by $3.94, or $10.25 a month, or $204.88 more per year. Additionally, I would first recommend maxing out your Roth IRA and employer-sponsored plans, such as a 401k, if available, to take advantage of the tax benefit, especially because the taxes on cryptocurrencies and their gains are likely to go up in the future. And this time into the future for your money to grow is what we need in order to make you rich and wealthy. The crypto world can be a little tricky, so here's a quick guide to getting started with Celsius, with no cost. First, make an account with Gemini, which is a cryptocurrency exchange, meaning you can buy and sell cryptocurrency through their platform. In order to transfer funds, you will need to verify your ID, and this may take a couple of days. In the meantime, you can link your bank account and transfer in US dollars at no cost. Next, you can convert your USD into GUSD, Gemini's stablecoin, at no charge. The Gemini dollar is audited frequently to guarantee that the company holds equivalent cash assets to its stablecoins in order to guarantee that one-to-one value ratio. Once your funds have cleared, your dollars converted, and your ID verified, you can transfer GUSD from Gemini into your GSD wallet in Celsius. And that's it. Now you're earning 8.88% interest on your money and will get a payout every week on Monday morning. The great thing about using the combination of Gemini and Celsius is that, at least as of recording, you will not incur any fees to withdraw or transfer your funds. Gemini allows for unlimited withdrawals of Gemini dollars, and Celsius allows for the same of any asset on its platform. Of course, interest rates on these crypto lending platforms change over time, so it's important to monitor their communications to make sure you're up to date. You may also want to transfer funds from one app to another if one offers a better interest rate, but please do your research diligently. Now, Celsius also offers great rates on Bitcoin and popular altcoins such as Ethereum, Dogecoin, Stellar Lumens, Polygon / Matic, and many more. So if you want to invest in a cryptocurrency and either don't want to get into staking because of technical issues or because you don't want to assume its risks, you can transfer your eligible crypto into Celsius and start earning passive income on your existing assets. And this passive income will, of course, compound over time. So in summary, getting rich on crypto is very similar to getting rich through traditional means, investing using the knowledge of the future value of money. This means that with time, your money can start making money on itself through investing. Even if you have nothing invested, the best time to start is right now, because your money will have the most time possible in order for it to grow. In my opinion, the best way to do this in the crypto space is with cryptocurrency lending platforms, and by investing in coins with a higher interest rate and less volatility, i.e. stablecoins. My platform of choice for earning passive income with crypto is Celsius. because it offers the best rate, as of now, for earning interest on stablecoins. And you yourself can get started today by using my promo code in the description to get $40 worth of free Bitcoin from Celsius. So please, guys, if you enjoyed that, please like the video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified. I have new videos coming out every Friday covering things like finance, investments, personal finance, self-help, you name it. Please comment down below, tell me what you liked and disliked about the video, what I can do to improve. Click the video that's coming up on your screen soon to watch another one that you're going to enjoy, and please add some music, crypto, or whatever else it is that you love to your day. Add some music. Just add some music.